I am a big fan of having only one data source and update all my files with that source. Today, I want to show you how I do that with Power Query. For example, here I have a group of pivot tables, and I have added the information for 2020 to my data source. You can see how easily it is just to update by refresh all. You can see here all the information for 2020 has been added to all my pivot tables. And the best part is that all the files that I have connected to that source will update as well. Here I have a dashboard that has information from 2017 to 2019. And because it has the same source, go to refresh all. In no time, the information from 2020 will be added to all the charts and all the slicers. So here we have 2020 included here, and you will see it as well in all the charts. My name is Alejandra, and I'm very happy to share this tip with you. If you like what you see here, please consider subscribing, and let's get started. I'm gonna start with a blank workbook. Just want to remove the grid lines. Go to the data tab, get data from file, from folder. My folder is here, demo, and I said open. And you can see the files that are included in that folder. I have two files. I click at transform data. Here we have our files. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create new queries from a reference. So anytime that I change anything where the folder is located, I just need to change it on this first query. I right click at demo and click at reference. I'm going to change the name, so I can double click here, or I can change the name over here on properties. Double click there. This is going to be called accounts. I need to create my other query as a reference, and I double click there again, cost centers. Same thing, one more. I need three in total, and I can press F2 or I can just double click. It doesn't matter. And this will be actuals. I'm going to connect my actuals with accounts and cost centers. That's why I'm creating three queries right now. So I go to the accounts query and I want to get the information from this file. So I just click at binary and you will see I have two tables there and I want the account name table. If I click at on the right here from this cell, I can see what that table has. Account number, name, category, and type. That's what I need. I click at the table. I have my table here. Here I have text type. Same thing here. Everything is correct. Cost center. Now let's go to the same file. Go to binary. Now let's select the cost center table, which has cost center and province. I click a table. I have the correct type here. It's text and text. I don't need to change anything there. Now I go to the actuals query and I need it from the second file and I click at binary and I have only one table. Click at table, that's what I need. And I need to make some changes here. The first thing that I need to do, I want to unpivot the information from store 1 to store 8 so I have the data correctly for my pivot table. So the first thing that I do, I select the first three columns. I right click and select unpivot other columns. And now we have the information correctly. This is a text type, cost center. The account number is a text type. Now the year needs to be a whole number. So I click in this little square and I select whole number. I need to change the title. I double click there and I say this is going to be the store column. And the next one is it needs to be a whole number, so I'm going to change it here. Also, I need to change the title. This will be amount. Now I have the information correctly. I go to home, close and load to, and I want this to be in a pivot table, and I want it in the existing worksheet. You will see that automatically the information has been added to the data model. And I say, okay. So you will see our queries here are getting uploaded. I have four queries. Now I need to make the connection between the tables. So to do that, I can go to the Power Pivot tab and go to Data Model and click at Manage. Or I can go to Data and here in Data Tools, I click at Go to the Power Pivot window. And here the Data Model is opening. You can see here I have four tabs. Those are our queries. That's what I'm looking for. Go to diagram view. I don't need the demo query. I don't want to see it on the pivot table. Then hide from client tools. Here I have the three tables that I need to work with. Then I can connect the accounts table with the actuals table. I just click and drag. I make the connection between AC and account number. By doing this, I don't need to work with any XLOOKUPs or VLOOKUPs. This is making the connection for me. This is one of the great things that is working with Power Pivot and Power Query. Now, the next connection that I need to do is cost center with cost center between these two tables. And you can see that there is one connection to many. Same thing with the account, one connection to many. That's all that I need to do here. I'm going to close this. And then I'm ready to work. My first pivot table will be the expenses. I want to bring the province on the rows. I want to bring the year on the columns, and I need to bring the amount for the values. So I don't need the grand total here. I need to remove it. I just need the total per year, but no for all the years. Perfect. Now, what I'm gonna do is create several pivot tables. When working with several pivot tables, I recommend that you create one pivot table per sheet. This is because in case you add columns or rows, there is no chance that they will overlap other pivot tables. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm having several pivot tables on this sheet, but it's just to show you how it will update once we refresh our data source. We are very close here to finish. Once we're done with the pivot table, we can go to our source. I have it open here. This is my table. Go to table design. You can see that the table is called actuals. That's what we saw in the Power Query editor. And now what I want to do, this is the 2020 year. Press Control Shift down. And this is all the information for 2020. So I'm gonna select all those rows and then Control minus to remove. So now you can see I only have the information from 2017 to 2019, and I'm gonna save it. Keep in mind that Power Query will capture the information that is saved, not the information that you change on the file without saving. So be very careful of that. Save your data source before you update your report. Now let's go to our pivot tables. Here you see that we have 2020. Okay, let's go to data. Refresh all, and you will see how 2020 will get removed. You can see now how quickly and easy was to update that information. Now, let's say you had a mistake and you removed 2020, but you had to remove 2017 instead. Let's go to the source. Here I have the 2020 data. Copy and paste at the bottom, right? Because this is a table, the table will expand with the new information. So Power Query follows the table, not the range. So whatever you add or remove from the table, Power Query will capture that. So let me paste Control V. And now you will see that my table has been expanded. This is the end of the table with the 2020 data. And now I'm gonna go to the top and I'm gonna remove all the 2017 information. That's what I should have done in the first place. So here, because I have it sorted by the year, I know that this is only 2017. Even you can look at the filter, I have 2017 to 2020. Let me remove 2017, Control minus. And now you can see that the filter will have only 2018 to 2020. I say okay, I save it. Now let's go to our pivot tables, data, refresh all, keep your eye on here and all the pivot tables. I have 2017 to 2019. So all this information will update automatically with the changes that we just made. Now you see 2017 is not here anymore. Now we have 2018 to 2020 in all our tables, 2018 to 2020 and here and here. So that quickly and that easy is how we can fix this. I hope you found this information helpful. If you like it, please give the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, share with anybody that you believe can benefit from it. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Bye-bye.